Tom Lovelace, and welcome to the Lovelace Music Experience. On the show, we will talk about all genres of music and interesting interviews with special guests every week. We will be interviewing musicians, bands, DJs, sound engineers, music photographers. We'll speak with vocal instructors, guitar techs, drum techs. We'll talk about what gear works best for you. We'll speak with music schools along with local music teachers here in the Hudson Valley. We will also be talking to club owners as well as local venues. Wherever live music is played, we want to hear from you. We also invite you to call in. This is an interactive show. The number here at WTBQ is 845-651-1110 or 93.5 FM or 1110 AM. And hey, you can listen to us anywhere in the world. Just go to your smartphone or computer, type WTBQ.com, click the Listen Live button, and you can listen to us anywhere. So first and foremost, I would like to thank everybody that came in this morning. We have a full studio for sure, but a very special thanks to our sound engineer, Dan Bolger. Dan, thank you very much. Dan engineers the show every Saturday for us, and we very much appreciate that. So let's hop on the tour bus and welcome to the Lovelace Music Experience, music in sync with the world. My special guest today, we have a band in the studio, the Black Dirt Band. Good morning, guys.
Good morning, Tom.
Good morning, Tom.
All right, Tim.
Yep.
Let's start with you. Why don't you go ahead and introduce the musicians in the studio with us today?
Sure thing. Well, we couldn't get everybody in today, but we have our bass player, Lester Wilson, number three, the third, over here on my left. And then my brother, Tommy, over here on my right, who does vocals and harmonica in the band, and myself. And Tom is our honorary.
All right. Hey, that sounds great. I can carry the amps for you.
I got to pass the initiation.
As long as they're solid state and not those tube amps. Anyways, all right, guys, the Black Dirt Band. Why don't you go ahead and tell us a little bit about the band?
All right. We formed around 07. Lester, Tommy, and myself have been in a couple of bands locally. Crawl Space was one.
Crawl Space was the first. There was an ad up at Alto Music, and I made a call and met this guy, Charlie and Conrad, and we had a gentleman who used to play drum with us from Canada, nice guy. And then that changed into the OC Blues Express. We had that going for a while. And then we were the Black Dirt Band now, so it's changed a lot. The music is solid, that's all I can say, really.
Yeah, I've listened to you guys, and really incredible. You guys harmonize so well together, and I think it's great. We got a family thing going on here. So who's the boss of the band?
Well, you know, we have a joke all the time. Tommy would say something to me and go, "You ain't no band leader." And I do the same to him. Depends on who's doing most of the bookings during the time and who's kind of sitting on their hands. But
right now, Tim's the band leader.
So Tim gets all the credit or all the you-know-what.
We switch it up.
We switch it up. Yeah, it's an arduous task reaching out to all the venues and trying to keep yourself out there. You know, sometimes we play a lot more and sometimes we play a little bit less depending on schedules, but we try and keep it pretty steady throughout the year.
Right. Now, I know you guys played together with the Black Dirt Band. Are you guys involved in any other projects?
I play solo throughout the Hudson Valley here throughout the year. Lester does some bass for, who do you work for there, my friend? Want to give him some props?
Kevin Eggie, Wayne Fugate.
Wayne's a Broadway guy, plays incredible mandolin. Is it mandolin?
Yeah, he's an unbelievable mandolin.
Wow, very nice.
The great thing about Lester sticking with us, Lester used to tour throughout the country with a couple of different artists, I think. Some country artists as well as like Willie Dixon, I think you did. And
James Cotton.
James Cotton.
James Cotton, yeah. Okay, James Cotton, not Willie Dixon, I'm sorry. Tandy Tucker, I think, too. Yeah. So what Lester did was...
Pretty big names right there.
Yeah, yeah.
That's great.
And what made it even better is Lester, through his contacts, brought to our band a lot of supreme talent. I mean, Tommy and I are late blossomers, you know. I picked up the guitar when I was 36, I think, and I'm 37 now, so I've gone very fast. I'm just getting a little bit older than that.
Just say you don't look a day over 60.
Yeah, thank you very much. But luckily, all these guys, right. we've had a couple of changes because some of them are moving. Sometimes it's a little bit too far for them. We had one guy who was Bruce Kirshner, Broadway guy, played down the city a lot of Western swing bands. He was phenomenal. He moved to Texas recently, so we lost him. Skip Crevins, another Broadway guy, fantastic, yeah, incredible guy, so, you know, pedal steel, amazing, and he's out of the tip of Long Island, so we don't get him as much as we used to, so what I've been trying to do is trying to bring in some local talent to take over the lead duties, because I don't really do too much lead guitar, I'm not that good at it, but Lester's contacts, we have a guy named Van Manakis, who we always feature, I think you're going to play a song for him, for us, of his. And I got a local guy coming up, John Bendy, who's fantastic.
Yeah, he's good.
Yeah, he's going to be playing with us at an upcoming gig at Brian's Backyard Barbecue on April 7th.
So you guys have various musicians rotating throughout the band, depending on what the venue, what the gig calls for, things like that. And what I like about that, sounds to me like it keeps it fresh. It keeps it new. You never know what you're going to get. It's always exciting. And, you know, keeping it fresh is big out there. You know, how many times you go to a place and you're like, wow, this band is really great, but that's the same set list I heard the last four times. Okay? Not that saying that that's a bad thing,
just,
but...
we just gave each other the eyes because we do, you know, you do tend to repeat things because once you get them down, you nail them, it's like, oh, you're getting your comfort spot, you don't want to move on from it. But I do try to introduce some different tunes. A little bit outside. We do a lot of blues, and sometimes we do some rock, and I do try to bring in some stuff. And Tommy does too, but he's a little slower.
A little slower.
All right, how about the percussionists? We haven't talked about the drummer yet.
Yeah, we got John Clay, we're featuring now. His brother Herbie was with us for quite some time. But, you know, sometimes things just change. Herbie was great for us, a good fit. John's a great fit too, very available to us. He couldn't make it today, but yeah, he's fantastic.
Any other family members other than Tim and Tom here? Lester, do you have any other family that's involved in music, or is it pretty much just you?
No, my cousin Jack, he produced Aerosmith.
John Lennon too, right?
And John Lennon, yeah.
Aerosmith,
Elephant
I think I've heard of that man.
Yeah.
John
Elephant
Lennon, you heard of him?
Yeah,
Irish.
Yeah, his name's Jack Douglas. He, he's made his mark for sure.
So Tim, when did the bug bite you? When did the music bug bite you?
Well, I've always been a fan of music. You know, I grew up in the 70s, so you know, I had the classic rock thing that was there.
Right.
And my brother got me into disco. He used to force me to dance with him.
Yeah, my dance partner back then.
Is that why he's wearing that that flower shirt with the giant what do you call it?
The bells.
Yeah, with the bells and the giant wingtips.
That was a guy.
Yeah,
that was a guy.
Yeah, so he ventured towards disco. I kind of went to alternative rock, but it was really alternative back then. You know, some of the English bands I'm a big fan of. Fell into the blues eventually. We used to go see Bill Perry all the time.
Yeah, Bill Perry.
Who was a phenomenal local blues musician. Missed tremendously. And we actually had a chance to open for him once, which was fantastic.
At Hoover's Opera House.
Hoover's Opera House.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun.
Oh, that was a great place.
Sure was.
Yeah.
We used to love playing there.
Are they doing anything with that now? Anybody know?
There's a restaurant there, and I think they do feature music. I haven't gotten over there yet, but you know, I don't know what they do for the musical community as far as.
I try to convey this to the listening audience all the time. Imagine walking into a place. You know, you're out with your wife, significant other, whatever. You walk into a place. You got a nice little band playing. The restaurant or venue serves an outstanding dinner. Couple of drinks. I mean, what makes for a better evening? Hearing some live music.
Nothing.
Definitely exactly. Not a DJ.
Right.
It's fantastic. Music's the best.
Well, the DJs do have
their
place. Let's not pick on
the
DJs.
I'm just kidding. I love DJs.
Not really. Let's go pick on the rest of the show. DJs can be it. You know what? It depends on the setting, on the fit. I've been on both sides of the fence, and you know, I just think. For me personally, at this stage in life, walking into a place and seeing guys pouring their heart and soul out through their instruments, through their vocals, it's just an incredible experience. And when I was in the business, you know, it kind of, every time I would play a song, I'm like, man, how cool would it be to be actually playing that song and not just spinning that record and making music and getting into making music. We're going to talk about a few guys. Any original tunes, and I think we're going to also play a song when we come back live in the studio.
All right.
All right, folks, we're going to take a short pause, but before we do, once again, we're in the studio back with Tom, and you're tuned in to the Lovelace Music Experience Music and Sync with the World. The phone number here at WTBQ is 845-651-1110. And if you just tuned in, we're in the studio today with the Black Dirt Band, and I do believe we're going to hear a live song right here at WTBQ Studios. All right, Tim, take it away. You done me wrong, babe, and you don't know how sorry. Gentlemen, the Black Dirt Band.
Hey now.
All right, we had Lester on bass, Tommy on the harp, otherwise known as the harmonica, and vocals. Incredible vocals. How long have you been singing?
I don't think since we were kids. I mean, you know, always listened to the Beatles. I'm a big fan of the Beatles. Always have been. And rock, blues thing came a little later on. R&B. I like it all, really. Some country. My kids do some music too. My daughter plays guitar. My son does some rap music. Actually, he's pretty good at it.
Rap, I think, is pretty difficult. I mean, I've never tried it, but I don't know how they can talk so fast. Actually, makes
sense.
He's
pretty good.
And of course, that was Tim on the acoustic guitar. Excellent job, guys. All right, let's talk. How do we go about booking the Black Dirt Band?
Well, we have give us a Gmail.
Thank you very much. All right, Tim, what do we got?
I would do a Bob Dylan cover, I Shall Be Released.
All right.
Released.
We got Lester on bass. We got Tommy on the harp again. Yeah. Tim, you're going to be playing acoustic and singing this
Yes,
track.
Sir.
All right, very good. Let's hear it.
All right. They say everything can be replaced. They say every distance is not near. I remember every face.
protection. They say every man must fall. So I swear I see my reflection somewhere high inside these walls. I see my light come shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any way out, I shall be a lonely crowd. There's a man who swears he's not to blame. All day long I hear him cry so loud, calling out that he's been framed. I see my light come shining from the west down to
again, how do we get a hold of the Black Dirt Band for bookings?
Well, you can reach myself at the blackdirtband@gmail.com, and you can also click the email buttons on Facebook for the band at Black Dirt. Well, it's Tim A. Black Dirt Band on Facebook, and for the solo stuff for myself, it's TJ Santiago. You can find it there.
All right, there you go, folks. Go ahead and book the Black Dirt Band. They just gave you, just a taste of what their capabilities are, and these guys have been around a long time. They're not new to the game by any stretch of the imagination. Hey, you just ripped your shirt.
Woo! Working out.
All right, so let's talk about working out. How often do you guys get together and practice?
Well, this is the funny thing. We rarely get together as a band to practice. I think we're going to get together once with John Bendy before the gig at Brian's. It's going to be great. We're not worried about it, but just to get everybody on the same page, which is pretty easy. But traditionally, we don't really do too much rehearsal.
How do you decide the song selection?
Well, we got a group of songs we've been playing for some time.
Okay.
Throw in some different ones here and there. We have a large catalog of songs we've been doing. So it depends where we're playing, what type of club it is. We switch it up. You know?
Speaking of clubs, what's some of your favorite venues? I know we touched on it earlier. What would you say is, top of the list?
I think Brian's is a great place to play. He really appreciates music and has the right setup for bands there. Golden Rail's been really good to us.
Yeah, that's a lot of fun.
Whiskey Alley. That's in Goshen, the Golden Rail?
Golden Rail's out in Town of Newburgh.
Town of Newburgh,
yeah.
Okay.
There's a couple wineries we do. Brotherhood Winery has us back every year, which
right.
is great. Thank you, Brotherhood. We're going to be doing the Applewood Winery. We did that last year before. We're back again, which is great.
St. Augustine Bazaar, which we do every year.
Yeah, it's up in
Highland. It's a nice fair, family type of thing. It's nice stuff.
We're gonna get together. We were practicing a couple of things recently, and I said, you know, we're not getting any younger, and it's not like we're gonna strike gold, but let's get something on record and do something. So we're gonna do something. We just started working on some originals. So.
Way overdue.
Yeah, that's for sure. You guys definitely gotta get into the studio, and you know, we had a sound engineer in here. I guess it's been a couple of weeks ago, and Mike Matheson, he owns Menacing Sound Lab out in Westtown. The rates are very reasonable, and really, guys, we want to hear a CD, you know. Yeah, and definitely. So, but anyways, I just see through the studio window that Heather Howley just arrived, and she's from Independent Helicopters, and we got a special feature coming up. It's going to be the Lovelace Showcase featuring Independent Helicopters here at WTVT Studios. Once again, I would like to thank my guest, the Black Dirt Band.
Thank you, Tom.
Appreciate
it's a pleasure.
It was great having you guys in the studio. Your music is absolutely first class.
Thank you
so much.
Let's do it again.
And stay tuned for part two. We'll be right back, folks.